At the end of this decade, the International Space Station will cease to exist. In orbit around our planet since 1998, the orbital laboratory housed over the years hundreds of members of the human race, who conducted thousands of experiments that helped advance our knowledge about pretty much everything around us, in ways we're yet to properly comprehend. The reasons why NASA consider putting down the ISS have to do with the place becoming old and increasingly hard to maintain in a safe manner for its occupants. NASA does not plan to replace it with a structure it itself designed, but will likely rely on the space stations currently in the works at the hands of a number of private space companies. NASA calls these habitats commercially owned and operated low Earth orbit stations, and to help with their development it runs something called the Commercial Low Earth Orbit Development Program. It's an effort heavily backed by Axiom Space, Blue Origin, and Starlab Space, but other organizations are welcomed as well. One of the crews working hard to be officially recognized as the maker of the ISS successor is a startup called VAST. We've recently talked about its ambition of creating what it describes as the world's first commercial space station, the Haven-1. The orbital structure has been imagined as a 328-feet-long structure comprising four private crew quarters, a common area, and a workplace called the lab. The station is meant to serve the needs of private citizens, governments, or companies, as long as they pay an undisclosed price for the services provided. The habitat also forms the basis for something VAST calls the proposed successor to the ISS. Presented during the 75th International Astronautical Congress, which took place earlier in October, the station is called Haven-2 and it is, in essence, a beefed-up version of Haven-1. Haven-2 relies heavily on NASA deciding to call it the official successor of the ISS to become a reality, and a decision on that is expected to be announced in 2026. If it gets the space agency's thumbs up, this is how it's going to shape up. The first module of the Haven-2 should become fully operational in 2028. The hardware itself will be 16 feet longer than the ones that would have already been used to build Haven-1, and that means it should offer twice the livable volume. The first module would be joined in orbit by three others by the end of the decade, each of them adding more advanced and efficient life support technologies. On top of that, the modules will also evolve in terms of payload capacities, and once assembled they'll form something that looks like some sort of orbital train. The lab on the Haven-2 will be able to support microgravity research and in-space manufacturing, and it will be roomier and more capable than the one deployed on the first version of the station. From 2030 to 2032, VAST intends to launch a core module that is larger than all the others already in orbit, offering a 23-foot diameter. Four more regular modules will be added, bringing the total, core included, to 9 and changing the shape of the station to that of the plus sign. Just like Haven-1, the two will benefit from the deployment of windows of unprecedented size and disposition. The main cupola will be almost 13 feet in diameter, for instance, and a total of 16 dome windows, two for each module, minus the core, each measuring 3.6 feet, will adorn the sides of the station. The laboratory will also have the ability to host external payloads. A robotic arm will be on deck to help move that and spacecraft around. Visiting spacecraft will be able to berth and unload, or load, cargo through a payload airlock. Another airlock will be dedicated to extravehicular activity missions. It remains to be seen whether NASA will choose the VAST design or go for something else. For now, the agency is busy planning the safe deorbit and destruction of the ISS. In the summer of this year, the agency announced it is giving SpaceX the contract to nudge the laboratory out of its orbit and into our planet's atmosphere. The demise of the 450-ton ISS will come about as a combination of the station's natural orbital decay and the purposeful towing action of a SpaceX spacecraft. The ship is for now called the Deorbit Vehicle and details about it are not known. The ISS is scheduled to fall from the sky and burn, mostly, in Earth's atmosphere. What's left of it will rain down on remote and completely uninhabited waters somewhere on this planet. The Deorbit Vehicle will probably be destroyed on the job as well, given how it's meant to sink into the atmosphere while attached to the ISS. We'll keep an eye out for more projects being submitted as part of the Commercial Low Earth Orbit Development Program and report back when we learn more.